All rise and come to order. The Superior Court of Dawson County is now in session. The Honorable Bonnie Chessher Oliver, now presiding.
Just a minute, my court reporters.
Can I approach on two?
You may.
And Judge, I know Mr. Mike told you he would get you that order on Kendall. We'll get you an order very shortly. Thank you, Judge.
Mr. Harvey here?
He is. You want me to get him?
Yes.
Sorry, hot ears.
I'm hoping, sir.
Let's finish this and we'll just pick out an answer.
Ready, Jess?
I'm ready.
Say we call Johnny Burt, please. Raise your hand, sir. Swear the testimony you're about to give in the matter of the state of Georgia versus Nydia Tisdale. Is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
You have a seat, Mr. Burt.
Thank you.
You speak clearly in the microphone, please.
Okay.
Could you state your name?
Johnny Ralph Burt.
All right. And what do you do for a living, Mr. Burt?
I mainly farm, but we got an agro-tourism operation.
All right. Where's the agro-tourism operation located?
5 Burt's Farm Road, Dawson, Missouri.
All right. And is that also the location of where you mainly farm?
No, we're from the different locations in this county.
All right. Go into the 5 Burt's Farm Road location. I want to direct your attention back to August 23rd, 2014. You remember that day?
I do.
Okay. Now, that location, did you host a Republican rally?
Yes, we did.
All right. Who owns that property?
Me and my wife, Kathy Burt.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies from Dawson County?
No.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies maintenance farm from the city of Dawsonville?
No.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies maintenance farm from the state of Georgia?
No.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies from anyone other than your own labor to maintain this farm?
Goodbye.
How long have you owned that farm?
It's been in my family for 5 generations, but I took control of it in 86.
Before you?
Well, my granddaddy had it, my great-granddaddy had it, and his daddy had it. We got it during the landlocking.
Okay, now, is Burt's Farm open to the public every day of the year?
No, sir.
Is there a time to do that it is open to the public?
Yes, sir.
When would that be?
September 1st through November 10th.
Now, Now, with that, the months of operation that were in place, and August 23rd was under the same operating schedule.
No, sir.
What was the operating schedule back in 2014? You remember?
Same.
Okay, so it was the same. Now, do you recall who contacted you about hosting the rally?
Mr. Beard.
Did you work out an agreement through Mr. Beard for payment for hosting the rally?
No payment, no.
And did you employ any security for the rally?
Did not.
Was there security present?
There was.
And who was that?
Captain Tony Wooten, the Dawson County Sheriff's Department, sir.
Remember what he was wearing that day?
He's wearing khaki pants and a black, like a polo shirt with a Dawson County emblem on it.
See whether he had a firearm on?
He did.
See if he had a badge on?
He had one on his belt, I believe.
Right, and then on the 23rd of August, did you encounter the defendant in this case, Ms. Tisdale?
Not till all this broke out, you know.
Okay, but when as you were, all this broke out, did you encounter her then?
Actually, she was in the barn.
All right. Do you recall what led up to her being in the barn?
I do.
All right, could you relate that to the court, please?
I will. All right. Me and my wife, Kathy, were sitting facing the audience on the left, further way down. David Perdue was sitting directly behind us. I've been talking to him a little bit. And, Governor Deal and Sandra were sitting at the front, kind of leaning. So a lot of the other speakers were up front. So Mr. Burgess and Mr. Bearden came over. And I noticed Ms. Tisdale sitting there on the camera, and she was sitting in a position like this, not relaxed, but forward, right close to the speaker. So I called him Clint. He came up to me and him and Mr. Burgess and said that members of the Republican Party were uncomfortable with it.
Let me object to that as hearsay, please.
No, you're safe, sir, being testified to in court.
No, it is hearsay because it includes conversations from, quote, members of the Republican Party. It's actually double hearsay.
Tell me that.
Yeah,
what was told to the person telling him something?
Well, I'm not offering it to the truth of the matter asserted anyway. I'm asking him based on what Mr. Burt did or what he believed the situation.
All out only for the person.
Right, I have no idea whether or not these people said that or not. What did they tell you, sir?
They said that some of the members of the Republican Party were uncomfortable with Ms. Tisdale family.
Okay, let's stop right there. This is just Mr. Beard and Mr. Burgess.
Correct.
All right, did you talk to anybody else or any other members?
Not at that time.
Okay, all right. Let's continue.
Okay. And I told Clint, I said, well, just ask her to cut it off. And he said, I already have, and she won't do it. So at that point, we went up, and Captain Wooten was up in the area. If you're facing like the speakers, with the right of the speakers, there's like a little gate there. We go in and out to get the tractors for the hay rides. So he was in that area there, and I told him what's going on. And I said, Tony, would you ask her to cut it off? If she won't cut it off, she'll have to leave. And I directly requested Captain Wooten to do that.
All right. Now, did Captain Wooten move away from you at this time?
No. I think he turned it. Well, I know he turned the talk to Clint. I went back and sat down. I had to go around to keep from getting in front of her camera and in front of the people. I had to go back around the sort of the back of the audience to, and I didn't sit back down with my wife, Kathy.
Okay. So now were you able to observe what was going on around Ms. Tisdale's area?
I didn't really to a lot of screaming and thrashing stories, so hollering and thrashing, don't say screaming, hollering.
All right, so you were describing hollering. What did you observe?
Well, when I first observed it, Tony was standing beside her, and she abruptly said no, and that got my attention. And I looked, and she started thrashing at him at that time. So Tony looked at me bewildered, like what I didn't
see. Can I object to that, please?
Well, that's his characterization of what he saw. Let the witness can describe it, how his experiences, it looked like.
He can testify to what he saw and what his impression was of what he saw.
And he said it looked bewildered like.
Well, and that's speculation, and I'm going to object to that.
Right. And it's your legal objection, because that's a characterization.
You'll have one cross, but I take it as this witness is impression of what he saw. You
understand? And Tony looked at me and he was like, what I do now? And I said,
objection. I assume that the same ruling may just have a continuing objection.
All right, and you did what? That's what I'm
gonna... I did my thumb and I said, get her out of here. And so he proceeded to try to remove her, and she was resisting.
When you said she was resisting, what was she doing? Well, I want to talk about what was thrashing. What do you mean by thrashing, Mr. Burt?
She had a camera hearing this and screaming and hollering. Well, yes, she got to holler no, and he had to take some kind of action, you know.
All right, so now you said he got her up. Did you see exactly how he got her up?
From my vantage point, I couldn't see his hands right then.
Okay.
We had people between right there.
So, but at some point she's up, right? What did you witness after that?
She was fighting him, and she was so violent, he had to take her left arm and put it behind her back. She had her camera in his face.
To fight him, did you see her swing at him?
When he got her up, we got a grain bin there, a corner grain bin that's close to the barn. When he got her up there, he had her arm, and she tried to hit him with the camera then.
Right.
Let me
object to that she tried to hit him. As opposed
she swung to at him. I'll rephrase that.
So it calls for a speculation about a mental operation. She say what he physically saw, not what she tried.
He corrected that, Judge. So, and just repeat what you said to Mr. Harvey, was an objection.
Just what you saw.
What you saw.
What I saw.
Yes.
She swung at him with the camera.
Okay. All right. Were you able to watch her exit from the speaking area?
Yes.
We keep referring to the speaking area. Do you have a name for the place where the speaking was doing? What was it?
We call it the gourd shed.
The gourd shed.
Yeah.
All right. For reference. Thank you. All right. But were you able to watch Ms. Tisdale's exit from the gourd shed?
I was.
What did you see?
Tony had to forcibly make her go that way with her arm behind her back.
Was she saying anything to you?
Oh, yes. Yeah, she's screaming, like, identify yourself. Who are you? And that's basically it.
Now, did you follow Deputy Wooten and Ms. Tisdale?
Did not, right at that time.
At some point, did you get up to go see what was going on?
After Sam Owens came over and talked to me, I did.
Okay. I don't want to go with what Mr. Owens said.
Okay.
But, all right, so after Mr. Owens spoke with you, did you get up then?
I did.
Okay. What did you do?
I walked in the barn, and she was still hollering and screaming, let me go, and who are you, and all this rehearsed stuff.
Let me object to that. We can strike an action to admonish the witness. Please just answer the question.
May I instruct the judge? You may. All right, well, Mr. Burt, I know this is hard.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Well, you phrased the word rehearsed.
Okay, I'm sorry.
The opinion.
Don't mean nothing. Okay.
What you may have seen or impressed. Arkansas, okay?
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Her arm was pinned behind the back on the kennel. She was over the kennel when I went in there. And the camera was sort of to her side. She had her hand on it that time, this hand. And she was still identifying herself, and she screamed out to Captain Burt, gave me permission to video. And I abruptly said, the owner of Captain Burt, and I said, well, I'm the owner. And I didn't give you any permission between my wife and the joint.
Now, where was Deputy Wooten positioned in relation to her this time?
He was over to the side of her.
You were saying to the side of her?
Mm-hmm.
Anytime you see him get directly behind Ms. Tisdale?
Did not.
How long were you in the barn area, Mr. Burt?
Mm-hmm. 3 minutes. Four. Not long.
Was Ms. Tisdale still being restrained?
That's correct.
Now, did you see who they control the camera?
Well, at the time she had her hand on it, and she was saying all that, it was like this.
Right. Did you see anyone trying to manipulate or operate the camera?
No, I didn't. Did
you see anyone press any buttons, like if you wouldn't push over hit any buttons or anything like that?
No.
Now, when you left, do you remember where the camera was?
It was sitting right where it was at when I left, but I was only there a short period of time.
Was it still in Ms. Tisdale's hand?
It was when I left.
Do you remember who all was in the barn when you left?
My daughter, Casey, my son-in-law, Jeff Sanders, and I think one of the politicians had come in there to see what all was going on with that. I believe it was Secretary of Labor, and I can't remember his name. But he came through in there.
Okay. Now, you said Ms. Tisdale didn't get your permission. Did anyone approach you to get permission for you to record?
Did not.
Prior to the rally day, did anyone review with you any policies about recording or anything like that in the Republican Party?
No.
Now, did you advertise the rally on your website?
No.
Okay, what about Twitter? Did you have a Twitter account back in 2014?
I've never had a Twitter account.
What about Burt's Farm?
Burt's Farm got one in December the 17th of 2015.
Do you recall whether you signed any documents you were gathering together?
I did not, no. I did.
Did you give anyone permission from the Republican Party to take control of your property for any reason?
No.
Saw Deputy Wooten restrained in court today.
I'm sorry.
You recognize the lady that Deputy Wooten had restrained in the barn today?
It's Ms. Tisdale.
Okay, any further questions at this time? Brief second, please. Thank you.
Ross? That's as brief as you
can. I can't even brief it.
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good morning, Mr. Hart.
I understand, Mr. Burt, that you've got a pretty nice place out there on Mr. Burt's Farm Road.
Yes.
And that it's a business that you all run, correct?
That's correct. Mm-hmm.
And during a certain season, it's a tourist attraction, correct?
We call it agro-tourism.
Okay. But you invite tourists and the public to come.
Correct.
And you invite them to come and enjoy the pumpkin farm, the pumpkin, and the things that you make there, correct?
Yeah, we also have agro-tourism.
Okay. And it's a pretty popular place, correct?
Well.
Yes, indeed.
All right. I mean, you know it, right? It's been around for a while. And everybody knows about it, and you, correct?
That's a matter of opinion, I'd say.
Okay. And what's your opinion?
As to rephrase the question, then, let's see.
Well, it's a pretty popular attraction, however you want to denominate it. Everybody in the county knows about it.
I guess generally.
and they know that you and your family run it and have been running it for a good portion of time.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Okay. So when, I guess, the political parties, like the Republican Party, they want to get a nice venue and they want to get folks who are known in the community, they call the Burts. You've done it before, correct?
Correct.
And so it's a pretty good venue, would you say, to get folks to come and to hear the speakers and to hear the Republican platform.
Yes.
Okay. And you, the Burt's Farm, has hosted that before, right?
Correct.
Okay. And having hosted it before, when you hosted it before, was it a closed meeting or was it open to the public?
Well, I never did any advertising. I cannot elaborate on that because okay. I don't know how it's advertised.
Well, did you or Burt's Farm have any policies related to behavior or filming or anything like that at the prior rally that you held?
No.
At Burt's Farm, okay. And at the prior rally that you had at Burt's Farm, did the Republican Party take the responsibility for advertising it or promoting it?
That's correct.
Okay. And at the prior event that you hosted, did you or the Republican Party, to your knowledge, have any policy related to published policy or policy that was announced with regard to filming or picture taking?
Not to my knowledge.
Okay. So the last time that there was a political rally at Burt's Farm, to your knowledge, the public at large was invited, correct?
Correct.
Okay. The Republican Party had no policies that were related to you, and you had no special policies for the Republican event, correct?
As long as everybody behaves.
That's kind of a general.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know,
people are on good behavior, we get along. Yeah.
I get it. But you don't publish something that says as long as you're on good behavior.
No. That is common human courtesy.
That's right. Exactly.
I
get it.
Good.
My page is just left.
Sorry. Yeah, there's not much room on these. And the prior round, do you remember, Mr. Burt, how many folks were at that prior round?
The one that we're particularly talking about.
No, the one before that. You said you hosted one.
Yes.
You hosted more than one before?
Actually, there's probably two before, okay. Three. Yeah.
All right, let's talk about those two or three, and that's
sure.
I'm going to work up to.
No, okay, we're talking. No problem.
At the two or three that you had before, would all the questions that I just asked you about the policies in the Republican Party and all that kind of stuff, those would hold for each one of those prior events, right?
Yeah, but I don't ever get involved in that.
All right. Yeah. You don't get involved in the advertising, promotion, internet presence, any of those things, those are all left.
Critter or camp, nothing.
Certainly.
Nothing, yeah, that's correct.
They're all left up to the Republican
Great.
Party.
Great, no, that's great.
And generally speaking, you're acting as a facility and a host.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm a host. Me and my wife.
And that goes back to when I said originally, it's a good place to host an event. And y'all are well known and well wanted folks in the community. So it's a good venue, right?
I would say so, probably.
At those prior events, about how many people do you recollect were present at the
Which prior? One? Which one?
Any of the three. I mean, just give me a ballpark figure. Were there 50 people, or were there 100 people, or one of them?
Well, we had one with for giving handouts. Probably 220 people.
It's a lot of folks coming.
When the governor announced, we had it depends on whether we serve them a meal or not, Mr. Harvey. People like to eat. And, you know, you have a better, and we didn't have time to cook the meal, so we did the pie thing. So
okay.
The other times we cooked meals and more people came, and, you know, they sit around and talk, enjoy themselves more, and it's more like a...
But there was no restriction, was there, on who could come?
Not my knowledge.
All right. Anybody, to your knowledge, the Republican Party promoted these events, including, hey, come and get the good food at Burt's Farm, but that anybody could come, and all were welcome, right?
As far as I know, I never restricted.
And was there any restriction that you knew of, to people either recording what the candidate said, or taking pictures of the candidate?
Yes, there was, that specific day.
No, I'm not talking about that specific day, I'm talking about
previously to this
yes.
incident here. Okay. No, I didn't.
Okay. Now, in the lead up to this specific day, there were, as far as you understood, the Republican Party, again, was responsible for promoting the event.
Yes, sir. That's correct.
And did you know that they promoted it on the internet?
No, I really wasn't aware of it. No, I'm so busy that time of year. Somebody else gets our emails. I don't have time to read the paper. I just work.
Okay. So here's my question.
Okay.
Do you know whether or not they promoted it, or the governor promoted it on the internet, or anybody promoted it on the internet?
If I stated that, it'd be hearsay, because I've been told and I didn't see it for myself. So,
okay. So the answer, I guess, for back then was no.
Right? Yeah. Okay, correct.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Did you see prior to the event any of the advertisements in any other publications like the newspapers? Or flyers or anything like
that? No, sir, I just said that I didn't have time to read the paper.
Okay. You got to ask
that's
about
fine. No, it's okay. I just clarified. Okay.
To your knowledge, just like the other events,
mm-hmm.
the Republican Party promoted, the event was open to the public with no restrictions on who could come, correct?
To my knowledge, yes, sir.
Right. And that was the understanding on August 23rd of 2014, right?
Right.
Now, you didn't have meals, you just had pumpkin products, right?
Yeah, we had pumpkin pie and pumpkin roll and drinks and water.
The judge was going to ask you yesterday if you could bring all of us a sample of pumpkin pie, but she didn't.
Mr. Harvey, I'd have been most happy. I would have been most happy and shared it with all of you.
Okay. Now, these events, people of course come at different times, and they kind of mill about the premises,
correct.
And they walk about and they look at Burt's Farm.
Yes, right?
And they're welcome. Y'all welcome everybody there.
Okay. As long as they behave, they're welcome.
Just like in school, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And people are free to wander around, talk to each other,
and
look at the facility.
Yes, sir.
Now, I didn't understand that there was not any public announcement about any limitation on who could come in, correct?
Yeah, as far as I know, that's exactly what it was.
There wasn't any sign-up sheet. In other words, you didn't have to register or sign up or anything.
Some of the politicians had their own tables there, and sure, it wouldn't, it's more or less information. It wasn't exactly what you'd say, a check-in sign-up, but they did, a lot of people did sign up.
Okay. The politicians individually wanted to get
Information for them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, great.
Voters' information and information about people that might support them and help them in their campaign.
Yeah, exactly.
But to get into Burt's farm that day, mm-hmm, to get into this political rally, yeah, they didn't have to check with you.
Well, no, absolutely not.
They didn't have to get permission.
No.
And they didn't have to get permission from any of the campaigns either. I mean, Governor Deal's people weren't out there checking, hey, do you have an invitation or do you have a registration or you can't get in without paying a...
No, that didn't happen.
Okay. So presumably that anybody who saw the advertisement or anybody that knew about it was welcome to Burt's farm.
Correct.
And I understand that Ms. Tisdale arrived and walked around, and we heard about her conversation with your wife. You weren't present for that
conversation. I was not present.
So whatever conversation was had, you weren't there and really weren't privy to that conversation.
That's correct.
Okay, that is correct.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when folks came into, and I'm going to say, the gourd shed.
That's right.
Well, because that's what it
is. Well, we know what, well, I don't know what you're talking
about. Exactly.
Okay, good.
When people first came in, the gourd shed is the location where the speakers were going to speak.
Right? Yes, sir, that's correct.
And as people were gathering and coming in to the gourd shed, mm-hmm, you and your wife were acting as hosts for the event and greeting folks, right?
Her and Casey were greeting them up front when they were first coming in. I went up to the barn for just a little bit, and I had to leave abruptly on account of some of the seating arrangements. I went up there the whole time. I told my wife and my daughter to stand in for me, that I had stuff I had to do. So me and Clint had to go do some seating changing and gourd shed.
Now, Clint, he wasn't working for you.
No, he used to, but he's an attorney now.
Right, he used to when he was a kid.
Yeah, he's a good guy, he's a good worker.
But he wasn't working for you that day.
Oh, no, sir, not at all, no.
As far as you understood, did you understand he was sort of helping coordinate with the candidates or the Deal folks?
With all the candidates, not necessarily just the Deal folks.
He was sort of facilitating what was going on.
Yes, sir, that's correct.
Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, he was also an MC. In other words, he introduced the speakers at the beginning.
Yeah, Clint has a good knack talking to a crowd, so I'm not very much of a good speaker. So when we have that, I always say, Clint, would you do this? And my son's a pastor, and we have a prayer before meal, he always does it, so.
Okay, but on that day, Clint wasn't working for you. Clint was helping facilitate everything. He knows you from way back. You asked him to make the announcement.
Absolutely, yes.
Okay, all right. You did stand, I'm going to go back in time just a bit. You did stand at the entry to the gourd shed for a time.
I wasn't standing. I was moving chairs.
Okay, well, let me see if you can help me here.
Sure.
And maybe if you can look at... Start you off with defendant's exhibit number 9. Okay.
Yes.
You need any glasses or anything?
Not right now.
Okay.
always did. That's the board shed, right?
No, that's the entrance to the barn.
Okay. Well, I thought you said the, is that where the candidates were?
At what time?
Is that where the candidates spoke?
At what? No.
Okay.
Absolutely not.
Was that where the meet and greet was?
Yes.
Okay.
That's correct.
Now, that's Defendant's Exhibit Number 9. Are there any signs? I see there are signs about Burt's farm. Are there any signs prohibiting the entry into that location by any people or prohibiting filming or recording or anything like that?
No.
Okay. Now, also, in the meet and greet, you were there for the meet and greet, right?
Like I said a minute ago, just for a little while, I had to go with Clint. We had to do some seating changes.
Okay, but you were there.
Oh, yes. Yes, absolutely. For a little while.
I'm sorry.
No, that's okay.
Let me give you number 10 and number 11.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's when I was there, and David Perdue just came in.
Okay.
And Clint, as you'll see, he's behind back over there, and he came and got me about some of the seat arrangements, and him had to leave and do some rearranging.
But you recognized you.
I did.
There. And you.
Unfortunately, it looks like me.
And your wife also there, correct?
Yes.
All right. Yes. Now, and have you had the opportunity, Mr. Burt, to see the video?
Just yesterday. I never looked at it till yesterday. Okay. You were playing.
So you've seen it?
Yeah, I have.
So you know that these are stills from the video, and that's how they've been introduced.
Absolutely.
And David Perdue, or candidate Perdue, had come in and was being filmed by Ms. Tisdale, and she had her camera up.
Okay.
And it looks to me like you're looking directly at her camera film.
I never saw her camera.
Okay.
You can't even see my eyes in here. How could you tell that?
See,
of course, I don't have glasses. Your eyes might be better than mine.
And
I can't see it.
And you can't see it as well on Defendant's Exhibit 12?
Well, if I had some glasses, I might. I'll be honest with you, Mr. Harvey, I just, let me warn you, my head's like a watermelon. I'm really stretching. No. My eyes are going to turn towards Mr. Perdue. There. Here. I'm listening to him. I'll be honest with you. I did not do that with the camera.
So you didn't see anybody holding a camera up?
No, I didn't.
Above their
head? No, I didn't.
About 6 or 7 feet away from you, filming the candidate as he came in?
That's right.
Did anybody come to you at that particular point and ask you about filming?
No.
At this particular point?
No, they didn't.
All right. When the candidates had come in, and then they went, I guess everybody got called over to the board shed.
Mm-hmm.
Clint got up and he started, I guess, the speechifying part of it.
Yeah, he's sort of trying to get everybody to come in so he could get started.
Did he say, he didn't say his name, do you recall that?
I really don't. I just saw it yesterday and here's the only time.
Well, would you disagree with me if I told you that he didn't say his name?
I can neither agree or disagree.
Okay. Okay. If the video shows that, the video shows it, right?
That's right.
Did you hear him? Do you recall hearing him say who he was?
To say for certain, I cannot do that.
Okay. You can't.
No, I came right off the top of my head.
Did you hear him make any announcements about any policy about filming or videotaping or audio taping?
No.
Okay.
No.
Do Do you know a man named Brian Pritchard?
I don't know him. I've heard of him.
Okay. Did you see Mr. Pritchard there taking pictures?
Did not.
Okay. Or audio taping the candidates?
Did not.
Okay. Did prior to this event, did any candidate come to you, Mr. Burt?
Candidate?
Hold on. Any candidate come to you and say, for example, I don't want anybody filming me?
Candidate?
Yeah.
Specifically candidate?
Candidate, that was my question.
No.
Okay. I then understood that Ms. Tisdale, you saw her in front.
Yes, yes, sir, that's correct.
She was pretty close to the candidates.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And I think you gave us somewhat of a little demonstration. You said she was holding her camera up and out front.
Seated like this.
Right, sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's correct.
And she was holding it out from her body towards the,
yes,
towards
sir.
The candidate.
Yes, sir.
And
yeah,
it's
correct.
Got kind of a viewfinder on there, on a little screen.
Yeah, that's correct. Okay. Yeah.
Now, Clint, or Mr. Bearden, he got up in it and started this proceeding going forward and handed the microphone over to the first speaker, correct?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
And Ms. Tisdale was sitting there recording.
Correct.
Now, at that particular time, you told the state on direct examination where a couple of people were seated. Governor Deal was on the front row, too, wasn't he?
Also his wife, Sandra.
Mm-hmm. And Governor Deal and his wife
mm-hmm.
were seated on the front row.
Mm-hmm.
They were seated on the front row on the right-hand side. Facing the speakers.
No, just the left. Oh, facing the speakers. Yes, you're correct. I'm sorry.
Okay. Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Because Ms. Tisdale was over on the left-hand side. Right?
That's correct.
And Governor Deal and his wife were about, I don't know, within 10 feet of Ms. Tisdale?
Possibly.
Okay. On the front row, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Attorney General Sam Owens was present, correct?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
You would talk with him, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Other candidates, Representative Collins, United States Representative Collins was there.
Yes, sir.
As well as the candidates who were speaking, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, I think you said that those folks were over on the right. Remember, we're facing the stage.
Right, okay. Yeah, well, my memory, I know Doug Collins was there because we always have an exchange kidding each other when we were around, so I've had a little exchange with him cutting up. Then standing to the right of my pickup, there was Doug.
But there was
there's two or three people with Doug there.
Two or three people there. Standing there, and that was to the right within, again, 10 to 15 feet of Ms. Tisdale with her camera being filmed.
It's a little further than that because they were up there at the door of the pickup and the bed's 6 feet long, so you'd add 6 feet to the 10 or 16 feet then.
Okay. Well, let's say
16. 16, yeah.
Okay. All right, that's fine.
Okay.
Clearly within the visibility range of the front row.
Yes, sir. That's correct, yes.
Now, Ms. Tisdale,
she was not asking any questions.
No.
Really, nobody was asking any questions. Everybody was kind of politely listening.
Yes, sir. That's correct. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. And Ms. Tisdale made no noise while she was filming, did she?
No.
She didn't ask any questions.
Correct? No.
She didn't while she was filming. Okay. Mm-hmm. Interrupt anybody.
No.
Okay. So there's no question that she wasn't misbehaving or acting like a school child, like you and I were talking about, right? Beforehand.
Not at that time. Yeah.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Sure. You understand I'm taking it step by step?
Oh, yes, sir. I understand. Yeah.
Now, and she was quietly going about her business at that particular time. Now, I understand there were a couple of people that came, I guess, to talk to you. The first one was a Mr. Burgess, is that right?
No, that's wrong.
Okay.
Him and Clint came, yeah.
Okay, he and Clint.
That's great.
Okay. And as a result of Clint and Mr. Burgess coming to you, she was close to the speakers. She had a camera. And was it someone from the Republican Party that requested that she stop filming?
What I was told, it was some of the Republican candidates were, it made them really nervous.
Okay. And that's what you were told by Mr. Burgess and Mr. Bearden?
I believe Mr. Burgess was doing the talking at the time.
Okay. Now, you said to whom? Well, let's ask her to leave.
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that.
Okay, what did you say?
I said, tell her to cut the camera off.
Okay. Now, and who did you say that to?
Clint Bearden and Mac Burgess.
Okay. And did you see both of them go back to talk with Ms. Tisdale?
No, they had already asked her, and they came to me because I was the property owner at that time.
So when you say they, had you seen both Mr. Burgess and Mr. Bearden already go talk to Ms. Tisdale?
I saw them up there. I couldn't hear what they were saying from that point.
My question.
That's fine.
You saw them, both of them, go up there together?
First Mr. Burgess, then Mr. Bearden.
Ah, okay.
Then they both came to me.
Okay.
Okay. Well, we're good.
That's fine.
Okay. Sure.
I understand you saw Mr. Burgess go talk to Ms. Tisdale first.
Correct.
That was before you talked to Mr. Burgess about this, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You then saw Mr. Bearden go, correct?
Correct.
That was before they talked to you.
Correct.
Then after that those first two times, they came back to talk with you, and then they went back again?
No.
Okay, who went back again?
The next person that talked to was Tony Wooten.
Okay.
Okay.
And did Mr. Wooten, Deputy Wooten at the mm-hmm. time?
Yes.
Or investigator, I'm sorry, I don't.
Captain Wooten.
Captain.
Yeah, there you go.
Did Captain Wooten go back by himself?
Well, after I had talked to him, but he talked just a minute. He stood there with Clint and Mac. I don't know what they're talking about, but they're standing there. I came back around behind the crowd mm-hmm. and seated myself with my wife again in front of Mr. Purdue.
Okay. But did you see Mr. Rubin go off to Ms. Tisdale?
I did.
And did he go up there by himself?
No.
Okay. Who did he go up there with?
Well, Clint and Mac Burgess was right there close to him. They were out to the side of it.
So three people went up there.
Yeah. Well, they were close. They weren't actually going up to her.
Where was Mr. Beard? Was he
behind Ms. Tisdale?
No.
Was he off to the left?
He would have been off to the left.
He certainly wasn't just sitting there behind her when you saw him.
Not at that time, before he had when he spoke to her.
But he wasn't sitting up there that third time? This is the third time?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right. And Mr. Burgess wasn't sitting there either, right?
No.
So it was Mr. Wooten by himself that actually engaged Ms. Tisdale at that time, correct?
At my instructions, yes.
And the answer then is yes?
Yes, in my instructions.
Good. Now you can add whatever you want.
Okay, that's
fine. But here's the question.
Okay.
It was Mr. Wooten that engaged Ms. Tisdale by himself that last time?
Yes.
Okay. You, of course, couldn't hear that conversation, correct?
That would be correct.
Okay. And where was Mr. Wooten? Was he behind Ms. Tisdale?
No, he was beside her.
He was to the side of her, but behind her, correct?
No. There were chairs behind her. She couldn't get in there.
He was on the front row.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great.
Was Ms. Tisdale still filming?
Not like this. She's like this.
Okay, like that.
Yeah.
That's fine. How long did that exchange last?
Not a few seconds, because she screamed no.
Okay, she screamed no.
Hollered no, or what do you want to call
it? Okay.
Real loud, no!
All right. Okay. And that would have been right there, correct?
Yes.
Right there while the camera was on, she was still holding the camera.
Yes, that's the truth.
And so we could hear her say loudly, no.
Yes.
Deputy Wooten, I don't know if you could see, Ms. Tisdale was sitting holding her camera up. How did she get out of her chair? Do you know?
At that time, she started thrashing and pointing with her camera, and and hollering. I could not honestly say.
Okay.
So whether she got up or Tony pulled her up, I couldn't say.
All right. But we do know that she was taken from that particular position back out of the gourd shed, correct?
That is correct.
Right. And
at my instructions.
You can answer all the questions that I don't know.
Sure. That's not a problem. Just ask.
I don't ask.
Okay. No, that's good.
I'm going to ask you just to answer the question that I asked.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Okay. We're good.
Ms. Tisdale was being taken out of the facility, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. And she was taken out of the facility by Mr. Wooten, correct?
Correct.
She still had her camera, correct?
Yeah, I don't know how she held on to it, swinging it like that, but she did.
I guess Mr. Wooten wasn't swinging her.
He was guiding her.
Yes. With her arm behind her back?
No, yes, okay. Yes, yeah, that's correct.
That's got it.
He had to.
Because she was saying no.
No, not because she was saying no, because she was fighting.
She was
that's
saying,
the truth.
Identify yourself.
Oh, yeah. Yes, okay. Yes, that's true.
Had you heard Mr. Wooten identifying himself to her at any time?
Not my knowledge.
Okay. And Ms. Tisdale, you heard her keep saying, please identify yourself, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
All right. And Mr. Wooten, she wasn't doing anything but being taken somewhere, correct?
She was fighting. Okay.
She was being taken somewhere forcibly, whatever she was doing.
Exactly.
She was taken somewhere
forcibly while she was fighting.
Okay.
Okay.
Now,
I guess it was a few minutes before you went from the board shed and, can I say, over to the barn? Is it to the barn or the checkout counter?
The checkout counter is inside the barn, so you can phrase it every way you'd like.
Okay. Over to the barn at the checkout counter. The next time that you saw Miss Tisdale, where she was, I guess, bent over the checkout counter. Is that right?
Yeah, he had a restrainer there.
No.
Okay.
I said the next time you saw Miss Tisdale was when she was bent over the checkout counter. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. And when she was, how long did it take between the time she was taken out of the rally to when you saw her at the checkout counter?
I was saying possibly 2.5 to 3 months.
Okay. During that 2.5 to 3 minutes, were you still at the rally?
Oh, yeah, I had no reason to leave.
Okay. Did you hear any screams at the rally?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And so you heard a series of, not just, I'm talking about please identify yourself, but just physical screams. You remember hearing some screams?
Oh, yeah, she disturbed the whole meeting.
Okay.
It was very embarrassing. Very immersed.
And one of the candidates, in fact, talked about that. He said, if you've been in politics long enough, you experience everything. Do you remember hearing that?
No, I really don't.
All right.
But it could have happened, but I don't remember.
Okay. Well, I guess one of the things that could be embarrassing is not allowing the public to film what candidates say in a democracy. Could that be kind of embarrassing?
As long as they behave.
Okay,
I see. Yeah, everybody has, I have a policy in my place. People don't drink, they don't insult other people, and they behave themselves. There's a highway up there that goes two ways. They usually find their way to it.
Okay. So, did you have any information that Miss Tisdale was drinking?
Oh, no.
Or that in any other way was doing anything, we talked about it before this event occurred, that she was just sitting there taping, correct?
Correct, she was taping.
And is there anything embarrassing about, in a democratic and open society, filming a political candidate's speech?
Objection to form. If he's asking his, in your opinion, I don't object.
Okay, in your opinion. Comma, in your opinion.
Your Honor, may I elaborate on that question?
Okay. Answer the question, then you can explain your answer.
Okay. Ask me the question one more time so I get it down correct. Okay. Sorry, Mr. Carter.
That's fine.
Sorry to put you through this.
Yeah. I'll withdraw the question.
Okay.
Now, when you got to the barn, the checkout counter, who was in the checkout counter?
In?
Yeah.
Nobody was in.
I'm sorry. Who was in who was at the checkout counter in the barn?
And it is referring to.
Well, who are the people there? Who are the people around?
In the barn.
Yes.
Or at the checkout counter.
Yes.
Which one do you want me to answer? I'm going to answer you more.
Around the checkout counter.
Okay. All right. I got you. I'm with you now. Okay.
Student.
Okay. And these specifics with me. All right. My daughter was standing there.
Okay.
Tony Wooten and Ms. Tisdale at the time.
And did you come in with anybody? Was Clint Beard in there?
No, I met Clint on the way back out. We got like a walkway, and I was going in, he's coming out.
Okay. And was Ms. Humberger there when you were there?
No, I think she'd already left. I'm not sure.
So you don't remember whether she was there or not?
She left.
Okay. Was your wife there when you came in?
No. My wife was still seated at the time. I went after I had said, you know, she said Kathy Burt gave me permission. And at the time I said, well, I'm the owner, and I didn't give permission, so.
Okay. Do you recall when you watched the video what you said was, I'm the owner and I said no?
Yeah. That'd be correct.
Fine. So if there was no conversation about I didn't give you permission, what you said was, I'm the owner and I said no, correct?
Yeah, there you go. You got it right there. Okay. Thank you.
And at that particular time, when you said that, Ms. Tisdale was already, she was bent over the counter. Either Mr. Wooten, who may have been behind her in the 4 or 5
He was not behind her, he was beside her.
In the 4 or 5 minutes where you weren't there.
I wasn't there, but the time I was there, that's all I can testify. You're telling me that he did, and I wasn't there, so I can't answer that question.
Do me a favor and allow me to finish my question.
Absolutely. Yes, sir. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Okay.
There was a 4 or 5 minute period,
yes,
before you got back to the barn, right?
Oh, yeah. That's great. Okay.
At the time you got there, Ms. Tisdale was bent over the counter. One of her arms was behind her back.
Correct.
And Tony Wooten was standing either to the side of her or but behind her and to the side is what you are telling us.
No, I am not telling you that at all. Okay. No, that is wrong. He was standing beside of her.
Okay.
And I was there. Okay?
That's fine.
Yes. Just so you understand.
Great. She was bent over the counter.
Great.
A law enforcement officer with a gun had her bent over the counter, correct?
Correct.
Had her, I guess, secured bent over the counter, correct?
He had to, correct.
I move to strike. Will you just answer the question?
Yep. Yeah, sir. Yeah. If you ask him straight, I'll answer. Okay.
And Tony, would you
comment now? You know, Mr. Greer will have an opportunity to ask you any questions on redirect as well.
I apologize, Your Honor.
She'll just answer the question. If you can explain your answer, feel free to do so.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Apologize.
Ms. Tisdale was bent over the counter, correct?
Correct.
Mr. Wooten had her bent over the counter, correct?
Correct.
Mr. Wooten had at least one of her arms behind her back, correct?
Correct.
She was at least in a secure position, correct?
Correct.
Okay. Mr. Wooten, according to you, was to her side, correct?
Correct.
Which side was he on?
Here. He would have been on the left side.
On the left side, okay? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So would he have had a hold of her left arm, as you remember?
Yeah, she had a right one on the camera.
Okay. At that particular time, mm-hmm, that's the time, with all that established,
mm-hmm,
that's the time when you said, I'm the owner and I said no. Right?
At the time, you mean the exact time or within so many?
Well,
in general time.
That's the scene,
uh-huh,
as you encountered it,
mm-hmm,
when you said, I'm the owner, and I said no.
That didn't, may I elaborate?
Sure.
At that time I came in, it was a minute or so of her yelling and all that, and after that she said, I asked Kathy Burt, gave me permission to film, and that's when I said it. It's
okay.
Probably a minute lapsed.
Okay. And that's when you said, I'm the owner, and I said no, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, that's correct.
Mm-hmm. Had you heard Mr. Wooten identify himself at any time?
No.
Had you seen, he says, while you were there, your wife talking with Ms. Tisdale?
No.
Okay. Did your wife come in while you were still there?
No, I went back out then.
Right. Was anybody else there? I think your daughter and just your daughter and Tony Wooten are the only people that were there while you were there. Is that correct?
My son-in-law, Jill Sanders, came in.
And how long was your daughter there?
She was there when I came in and when I left, so I really don't know.
Okay, how about Mr. Sanders? Did he come in while?
He stayed when I went back out to the audience.
Do you know when he came in?
Before me, but I can't really say the exact time.
Okay. Hold on 1 second, please. Okay.
Oh, thank you so much. Kind of.
I think I'll pass the witness at this time, Judge. Thank you.
Anything further, Mr. Greer?
No, Judge. Thank you.
You may step.
Thank you, Mom.
I'm going to call your next witness.
Come on.
Probably 16 and a half years.
Okay. And were you a post-certified police officer?
Yes, sir, I was.
And you're still a post-certified?
Yes, sir, I am.
What's a post-certified police officer?
This means I've been through the basic law enforcement academy and I have arrest powers in the state of Georgia.
Now, how long have you been post-certified?
Probably about 17 and a half years.
Did you work in law enforcement prior to the Dawson County Sheriff's Office?
No, sir, I did not.
You encountered the defendant in this case on August 23rd, 2014.
Yes, sir, I did.
All right, where did you encounter her?
Burt's Country Farm.
All right. Is that farm located in Dawson County?
Yes, sir, it is.
Where exactly did you encounter the defendant?
Inside the, what I've learned in the last few days is the gourd area, basically with the exit that your eyes where the speakers would be.
Okay. Were you in uniform?
Oh, well, I was. We have two different uniforms at the sheriff's office. One of them is our typical uniform that's the duty belt that we wear. Then we also have an alternate uniform, which a lot of agencies have went to. That uniform is the VDU pants, the tactical khaki style pants, and the polo shirt with the badge and Dawson County Sheriff's Office emblem engraved on. Also had a badge on my right side next to my gun, which is our policy.
Now you call it VDU, the tactical. Can you explain to the court what that means?
It's like a pant that's more made for comfort as far as like, khaki style. It's not, polyester that we normally wear in the summertime. Polyester gets really hot. There's just certain situations where we wear those type of uniforms. So it's basically like a khaki style pant that's got pockets on it for different things.
Okay. So, were you on duty?
Yes, sir, I was.
Were you being retained to pay any extra by the Fulton Party of Georgia?
No, sir, I was not.
About first form, did they give you any supplement?
No, sir, I was not.
Right. And what was your assignment there at first form?
Just basically security. You had the opportunity to have the governor, and you had several candidates running for office. And they come to Dawson County. This is not unusual. Actually, the night before, I served with the sheriff's office as security at another event. The prior night, I've done these several times, places where the governor's been, places where there's been actors. just to make sure that nothing happened while they were in our county.
Okay, and were you aware beforehand of this event?
Sometime that week I was made aware of it.
Did you volunteer to do this?
Yes, I did. I volunteered after being asked, so that's kind of a two-part question. Can I answer that or clarify?
Well, let's go into that. Who asked?
Clint Beard texted me and asked me. That's typical. I've been asked many times, like I said before, at other events, so I was asked by them. Then, as far as did I ask, then I asked the sheriff if he wanted me to work that event.
Okay. Now, what was the defendant doing when you gathered?
By the time, when I was approached by Mr. Burt and Clint, when they came over to talk to me about it, she was recording, so she was sitting on the front row from that general area. I don't know what they considered the front row.
All right. Now, you said that. Can you be a little more specific?
Well, toward the front, one of the speakers were. I mean, right up front. I don't know if that was the very first row. I don't remember if she was on the first row. I just know that she was up front. I think that was the first row, but I couldn't swear to it.
Okay. Now, did you know her?
No.
Describe your encounter with Ms. Tisdale for the court, please.
My encounter? Yeah. I went up to Ms. Tisdale. I watched as, I forget his name, but the guy who was deceased, that died not long after that situation, he was over there talking to her. And then when he walked off, Clint Beard walked over and talked to her. I believe his name was Mac. When he walked by, I didn't know who Mac was. I said, hey, she's not allowed to videotape her. They've asked for her to stop. At that point, he said, I just tried good luck.
Hey, let me object to what that person
But I don't need that. Full strike that.
Right.
I might give you a necessity session, but it's not necessary. It's not necessary. So, it's not necessary. So okay, so you had a conversation with Mr. Burgess. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. After that, what happened?
Well, I watched as Clint Reardon walked over there and talked to Ms. Tisdale.
Could you hear what Clint or anything they were talking about?
Did not.
All right. Now, after that, what happened?
Well, I watched Clint walk away and kind of looked at me and shrugged his shoulders. I'm not sure where Clint went, but then I went over at that point. We had made the decision that Clint would go first. Obviously, we've been in a situation many times in law enforcement where people may not know that they're not supposed to do something, so when somebody walks over and asks them, they simply stop. I went last simply because I'm a police officer. It's kind of more embarrassing if a police officer walks up and tells you, hey, you can't do something, than it would be if it was somebody else.
You said y'all made the decision about that conversation. Did Johnny Burt ask you to tell the after stop report?
He did. He asked both of us.
Did he tell you what to do? She didn't stop recording.
Told me that she didn't stop recording, really.
All right. Okay, so you make the decision then, I guess, to approach her. Can you describe how you approached her? Where from?
I approached her from the side. If you're facing the stage, I've been to the left. So I approached her. Come from the side angle, I was more of a, if you looked at it from a clock perspective, it'd probably be more between the 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock. I wasn't straight in front of her, but I wasn't to the side either. I was kind of at the side, more towards the side, towards the front, where she was standing as I approached.
Okay. Did you make contact with her?
I did. Ms. Tisdale looked at me as I walked over there and as I walked up to her.
All right. Now, did you speak with her?
I did.
What did you tell her?
I told Ms. Tisdale several things. I told her that I was being asked by the owner to come over and tell her that she couldn't record. At what point Ms. Tisdale said, I've spoken with the owner, and I said, I just spoke with the owner. He told me to tell you to stop recording, that you had to leave. I'm with the sheriff's office, and I've been told to come tell you that you have to leave if you don't stop.
Did she reply to that?
She refused again.
Okay. Did you continue your conversation?
Did try again, and I eventually said, I didn't know who she was, but I said, if you don't stop or leave, then you're going to leave me no other choice but to take you out and you'll go to jail.
Now, how long did you converse with her?
I would say probably 25 seconds, maybe 30 at the most, somewhere in that time frame.
Okay. All right. Did she stop recording?
No.
So what did you do?
Well, after I'd asked three times to try to get her to stop, I reached up and put my left hand in her camera area. It might have been in the front of the camera, it might have been on the camera, somewhere in that general area. I reached my right hand to her, I believe it'd be her right arm that she's videotaping with, maybe. And I said, come on, you have to leave. And at that point, before I could even start pulling up, she started jumping up. So I went up as she got up at the same time.
Okay. You have the conversation. Was she sitting down?
She was.
And were you standing up?
I was bent over talking to her.
Okay, so you've been over. Could you show how you were bent over? Stand up and show me a little how you were bent over talking to her.
She was like at his location,
She went closer, obviously, but she was like this computer up at this angle, and I was leaning forward to talk to her. Because I wasn't talking loud, I expected her to comply, and that to be in. So I didn't want to interrupt anybody else, including the speaker, obviously.
Now, once she's up on her feet, what occurred?
When she gets up facing me. So I've got her arm, and I had to move my other hand from the camera area to her other, to her arm. So I've got both hands on her arm, she's facing me. She's, you know, basically like swinging her arm towards me. So I'm trying to get her out of the place. I have no idea who she is. I have no idea what her intent is for that. My suggestion as a police officer, my best practice at that point was, I was already asked to remove her, was to get her safely away from everybody else.
How far away was Governor Jeff from her?
Not too far. I would say 5 to 10 feet, maybe, somewhere in that general area. Not far at all.
Is that a concern?
It's obviously always a concern when you're an officer. You're in an event where you have, you know, potential congressmen that's running for office, or state senator, I'm sorry. You have a U.S. congressman, you have the governor. When you have somebody go, like, start acting like the defendant did in that situation, yeah, it's a concern that you don't know why they're doing that.
So, gather up and you describe what happened next.
Yeah, and we start towards the barn area from the gourd area there, and she's fighting back. She's trying to push away, almost like to get away, like an intent from other law enforcement when somebody would try to get away and run. Not that I expected her to run, but she was trying to get away from
it. Can we object to that speculation or about the state of mind of this
Tuesday? Well, let me rephrase the question. Based on your experience, have you arrested other people in the course of your 17 and a half years in law enforcement?
Yes.
All right. Were her manners consistent with someone that was complying with your request?
No, sir, not at all.
Well, what were they consistent with?
Someone that would be trying to jerk away and in an attempt to get away from me.
So what occurred after that?
Well, I mean, I've got her by the arm. I've got one arm behind her back, so I'm trying to push her towards the barn area. She's doing things basically almost like she's twisting around. So I know I've heard that I've twisted her around, which is not true. My goal was to go in a straight line, closest way from point A to point B, straight line. So I was trying to get her to the barn area away from there. So I'm with the one arm behind her back, I'm pushing her towards that area.
Anytime she strike?
She did. In that area outside, I was kicked in the shin several times.
You ever hit the face by her?
Once we got inside the barn, I believe I was elbowed, not hit, but I was elbowed. I'm still.
All right, now, where was the camera during all this?
It was in her hand, and she still had it in her right hand. When we got inside the, were you asking inside the barn or while we're moving or both?
Let's go back to you just got up, y'all were moving out. Where's the camera?
Still in her right hand.
Right. As you lead her away from the door shed?
Still in her right hand.
Right. And then you're entering the bar?
Still in her right hand at that point.
All right. Now, did you ask her to cooperate?
I don't remember what was, once we got in the barn, absolutely. Several times I told her to stop fighting, I told her to stop many times.
And did you ever identify yourself by name?
I did. Toward the end, as I promised, when I told her if she'd stop resisting, stop fighting, I'd tell her who my name was. I told her I was with the sheriff's office when I approached. When she saw me, she looked directly at me. I had a badge, I had my gun, and I told her I was with the sheriff's office at that point. I don't remember, and I testified this to the grand jury, I don't remember if I said at that point my name is Tony Wooten. But as we got into the barn, I did tell her that when she calmed down, I would tell her. There's time after the videotape is off. There's quite a bit of time before the officers arrive at that point. So during that time, there was a time after the videotape stopped recording where Ms. Tisdale calmed down. At that point, we had several conversations that were more calm, and I explained to her who I was.
But as, and you've seen the video. Was she asking you to identify yourself?
She was.
Did you tell her name at any point there?
Not during the moving time. I mean, you know, I know that may seem for some people, but as a police officer 18 and a half years, you got somebody fighting you, and they're asking you who you are. I mean, the time to discuss names is not while somebody's trying to resist and potentially try to get away.
Once you get in the barn, can you describe how you secured her?
I did. We come in the barn. I'm somewhat familiar with Burt's Pumpkin Farm. Obviously, I've been there for years, you know, being with the county. There's not a lot of choice. There's a hallway that goes up to the top part, which is, you know, it's a narrow hallway. There's nothing I could do there. So I kind of played things in my head as I was going in. The only area that I knew that I could secure her and keep her from continuing to fight was that area that was the cashier checkout kind of thing, the counter.
All right, so once you have that area, how do you secure her?
I've been her over the counter there to basically gain control over her.
How did you do that?
Well, I had one arm behind her back still, so I basically just pushed her over the counter and leaned her up against the counter there.
Now, where was your body in position to her at this time?
Well, when we first come in, obviously, to get her there, I had to be behind her, so that situation, I was behind her. At one point, that's when I think she struck me with her elbow. At that point, you don't want to get struck twice, so I was to the side and had my left leg kind of up against her, kind of bladed, like we're taught in law enforcement, not to leave my gun exposed towards her. Obviously, she's still got a hand that's free, so for me, I bladed myself, putting my gun away, like we're taught, and had my left leg kind of up against her, so my body's up against her, but it's not directly up against her front to back.
Okay. Now that you're located there, you recall where that camera is at this point?
Still in her hand, still with you. All right. I did. There was one point where I thought that the situation, I had, like I said, I had one hand behind her back, but I felt like at one point that she had basically lost focus for a second, that I could get the other hand behind her hand, other hand behind her back, so I did reach up and take her other hand behind her back.
Now, once you had your other hand behind her back, and you said you've seen the videos, how do you contain her at that point?
Just hold both hands behind her back.
Where are you in relation to her then, position-wise?
Same position where my left leg is front. My back leg, my right leg is still kind of back to hold the position that I've got there, same position.
At some point, did other deputies arrive?
They did.
All right, do you remember how long it took?
Not exactly. I mean, I know, you know, that's kind of a rural area in Dawson County, so you don't have officers always close by, hence the reason why they asked for an officer to be there at that event. It took a little while. I'm going to guess 10 minutes, but I really don't know. I mean, it could have been 15, it could have been longer. I know it wasn't. When you're in a situation, everything seems like an attorney, so I'm going to say probably, I'm going to guess, let's guess 15 minutes.
15 minutes. And you told me that you identified yourself to her. Do you remember how soon before the deputies arrived you identified yourself by your name?
Probably five. If it was 15 minutes, probably 5 to 7 minutes, somewhere in there.
All right. Now, did you take, or what happened to the camera? That's the best way to ask the question.
The camera, at the time the incident occurred, or are you talking about after we left?
After that Ms. Tisdale, the other deputies have arrived.
Okay.
Let's back up. The deputies are up. Was she taken into custody?
She was.
Do you recall he took her into custody?
I believe he's Sergeant Russell Smith now, but I believe he was corporal at the time, come up and handcuffed her.
All right. Was she put in a patrol car?
She was.
All right. She had handcuffs on you?
I had handcuffs in the car. That was probably a mistake that I had that day as far as not having them on me, but at the point where you control somebody, it would have been no different to hold both hands than it was to be able to have the handcuffs there. I wouldn't have been able to handcuff her until I got the second hand behind her back anyway, so the handcuffs would have done me no good until I could get both hands behind my back, behind her back. At that point, I would have continued to hold her. Even if I had handcuffs, I already gained control. I wouldn't have taken a chance to lose control again.
Why wouldn't you put her in the car?
My car I had at the time was not equipped with a cage, so there'd be no way for her to be safe.
What the relevance of this is at this point, so I'm going to object.
It's relevant to what Ms. Tisdale testified in certain credibility, because he's impeaching what she said.
I didn't hear any testimony about
the cage.
Transport.
Right.
Well, not exactly those lines, but. I'll move on. Actually, I'm just done. Now, at any point did you grind your groin against your buttocks or anything?
Absolutely not.
At any point were you actually directly behind her when your groin was making contact with your buttocks?
The only time that it could have been possible was, like I said, when I first took her over the counter there, where I pushed her over the counter. I would have been at that point right behind her, obviously, but I told you, I mean, many times we've been trained to keep our guns bladed away. I would never be directly behind. That's an officer safety issue. Because through my training, I just don't do that. I don't do that. And most officers I know don't either.
You said she looked right at you. Did you make eye contact when you were approaching to try to resolve the situation?
Yes, she looked straight at me.
Now, she's in the patrol car, and I think that's how I got offline there. What happened to the camera?
The camera was taken. I took the camera and turned it over to Laura Bishop, who was the deputy at the time with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office, for several reasons. One, I wanted it out of my possession. Two, I still had to stay at the event. I didn't know much longer the event had. I didn't know at what point I'd be able to take that camera to turn it into this evidence.
Did you turn it off, turn it on, anything like that?
Look, the one thing you got to know about me is I'm not technical. I don't know how that camera turns on and turns off. So whatever it was in that state, it's the way it stays. Not working a rally. I've been to Burt's farm, but never as a rally.
Working as a deputy sheriff at a political rally.
I have not. I've been invited, but I've been out of the county for some.
So I'm going to confine my questions to that.
Okay.
Narrow focus.
I'll just make sure you know I've been there doing stuff, but not as a book rally.
But as I understand it, you have been detailed or volunteered to go to other political rallies where there were candidates and or governors or other politicians.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I would assume, correct me if I'm wrong, that every time you went to that kind of function, you wore the kind of outfit you wore on August 23rd of 2014.
Well, that would be a wrong assumption.
Okay.
Can I explain? Because you're asking a question, I'd like to explain why, because there is a difference in why we wear that uniform.
And I was just going to ask you that.
Okay.
But if I don't ask you the question, you can't explain, okay? I'm going to give you the opportunity.
That is the one thing. Go to another question, not being able to explain that.
No, that was important.
I'm with you.
You explained that was a somewhat of a seasonal outfit, as well as one that you would work that you would use at a function like this?
Well, I mean, the decision to wear those type of uniforms is made based on conditions. Like the night before, I'm not sure what I wore to an event the night before that was a political rally, but it was indoors and it was air conditioned. So the decision to wear khakis, polos, that kind of situation would be because it was outdoors. It's August, it's hot in Georgia in August.
Okay, so the decision as to what to wear, is that your decision?
It was.
And the other political rallies that you attended, did you always wear similar type clothing?
I think I just answered that. It depends on the situation and the environment that we're in.
Let's talk about the three or four rallies that you attended prior to this one. Do you have any recollection of those? You don't remember what you wore the night before? You just told us that.
Yeah, I don't know what I wore that one.
When was the previous time that
I've been at locations with the governor before? That's been several years. I have no idea what I was wearing. I don't know if I was wearing the polo style or if I was wearing the Class A uniform.
Does the governor have his own security people?
He does.
So the governor travels with his own security people. Are they state patrol?
They are. They're basically state patrol that's wearing a suit. You can't tell who they are. They're basically, they're not in uniform either.
So governor travels with his own security people, do you know whether or not any other of the candidates or politicians travel with their own security people?
I do not know. I don't know.
And how many folks, for example, do the governor, does security people, GBI, or state patrol officers, does he usually travel with?
I don't know that I can answer that, because I can tell you that I know how many I believe he travels with, but that may not be that accurate. They don't always come up to us and tell us all their ins and outs secrets of what they have there. I can give you my best guess, but I can't tell you for sure.
Well, suffice it to say that you know that he does travel with security. You don't know how many there were that evening, or really any other time, right?
I don't know how many there were. I know he had at least one that day.
And as I understand it, you've been to other political rallies, correct?
Yeah, I mean, that's the ones I thought about working in.
Okay. And when you worked there, have you worked in both public events and private events?
I really don't. Well, I think one time our governor did, I was at a public place. I was at one of the technical colleges, and I was asked to go down there as extra security. But I think that's the only time that I was in a public place. I think the others have been more privately owned locations.
In the privately owned, let's talk about the public location. Did you or were you aware how that event was promoted?
I was not.
At the event on privately owned property, were you aware how they were promoted?
I don't usually look at how people market or promote. Obviously, at some point during those weeks, I was either asked or told. I was in civic clubs here in Dawson County. I was at the sheriff's office. A lot of people knew me. They may have called me. I may have read the paper. I have no idea how I knew.
So the answer is no, you don't know how they were promoted.
That's what I said. And I just want to clarify.
You said a little bit more.
Well, I want to clarify why I didn't know or how I may have known. It's a complicated question.
Well, sure. Cause for an answer of no, you weren't asked why you didn't know. You volunteered why you didn't know.
To make sure I clarify. That I probably did know, but I don't know how I did know.
Well, then let's talk about the event on August 24th. At either of the public or private events that you were before, were there any restrictions on who could come?
I have no idea.
Were there any restrictions on whether or not the press was invited?
I have no idea.
Were there any restrictions on whether or not people could either record or film?
I have no idea.
And now let's talk about this particular event. You had been contacted some time before.
I was.
By Mr. Bearden, correct?
Correct.
And Mr. Bearden had texted you, as I understand what you said.
Yes, sir.
He had texted you at some time before and wanted to see if you would ask the sheriff allow you to come to this event.
He wanted to know if we were at somebody at the event.
Well, yeah, to see if it would be possible to have a deputy at Burt's farm, right?
I guess. I can't remember exactly what the text is verbatim, but something to that effect.
Okay. And do you recall telling him that you had already planned to be there?
I have to look at the text messages. I know that I told him that I would be coming at some point, but I'd be happy to look at the text messages and explain it to you. There's another page. One second. Yeah, I don't know how far before I said that I was planning on being at the event.
Well, the first text to you was from Clint Beard, correct?
Yes, it looks like.
Asking you if you could see if there was a deputy
sure.
That was going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And then that's your response, right? I planned on being there. I was already on top of it.
I was. I'm trying to explain to you. I was planning on being there. I was planning on going on or off duty regardless. I was planning on being at the event. That I, on top of it, meant I'd already planned to talk to the sheriff about the governor coming to town.
Okay, I mean, that's fine.
Okay, I just want to make sure I
clarify
for you.
In was a public event, right?
I believe they invited the public.
Yes, pardon?
So I believe they invited the public, correct?
Okay. And there was no question that it was a public event, correct?
Yeah, they asked the public to come, yes.
Okay. And you understood, did you not, that Clint Bearden told you that there was an ad, and once the ad stated all are welcome, it became a public event?
I've already told you, I have no idea how they advertised.
Well, didn't this part of the text train that you have with Mr. Bearden?
That isn't like the text that I exchanged with Mr. Bearden, no.
Okay. Well, you have no...
Is that not the text that was sent to me from a female, can't remember her name, but I don't believe that the text that was sent to me by Mr. Bearden, no.
Okay. You understand, though, that once an ad is placed inviting the public, it is a public event.
I've heard this, you know, obviously been in the courtroom, so I'd like to clarify since you're asking me what I think. I believe when you invite somebody into the public, yes, it does become, or you've asked the public to come, but I don't believe that in any way on private property gives, that it makes it all welcome regardless to what you want to do. So I give the example, like, even though you say all are welcome, I really doubt with the governor and congressman there, they were...
Excuse me, that's fine. Did you ask for an explanation of your thoughts?
Okay, can I explain? He asked me a question, my opinion.
You've already explained.
Your Honor, answer the question.
What was the question? Was it a public event?
Yes.
You wouldn't know whether I believed it was a public event once it had been asked to the public's invited. That's asking my opinion. I'd just like to explain my opinion.
Well, what is that? You need to give an answer, yes or no?
I can't give yes or no. I still believe that there's a yes with a cause to have other indications that you don't want other people there.
Right. Well, what were the indications that you had, that you saw? One, were there any indications prior to the time that you arrived that indicated to you that there were people that were not welcome?
I didn't see anything that said you were.
Was there any policy that you saw that said people were not welcome?
No.
Was there any statement by Mr. or Mrs. Burt that people were not welcome?
No.
Was there any statement by any of the candidates prior to the time that you arrived to you?
No.
That people were not welcome?
No.
Did you see any signs posted that people or anybody was not welcome?
Not that I know of.
Did you post anything that said any people are not welcome?
Did I post anything?
Yes. Did you post anything?
I didn't post anything about it at all.
All right. Did you make any announcement to anybody that certain people
No.
or professions were not welcome?
No.
Did you hear anybody else at the beginning of the rally say that people, certain people, aren't welcome to the public?
I didn't hear the introduction.
Okay.
I heard nothing else.
So was there any registration table?
Not that I know.
To sign in to get in?
Not that I know.
Was there anybody standing at the door taking an entrance fee or an admittance fee?
Not that I know.
Was there anything to suggest that it was not open to the public prior to the time that you arrived and when you first arrived?
That's where I guess we would have to agree to disagree. I think that to answer your question, I need more than yes or no answer.
What policy did you see?
I didn't answer my question.
What rules or regulations?
I answered that question. Didn't see any.
Were you provided any rules or regulations by anybody?
Not that I can recall.
So, what? Okay. Let's leave it at that. And you didn't see any of the advertising or internet presence or any of the announcements of the event prior to you getting there?
As I said earlier, I don't know how I knew it was there. I don't know if I saw it in the paper. I don't know if I heard about it from somebody. I can't answer that because I don't know. That is the answer. I don't know.
Did you see Ms. Tisdale when she arrived?
I did not. Not that I'm aware of, anyway.
Okay. How early did you arrive?
I think the event started at 3:30. I think I got there somewhere around 3 o'clock, maybe a little bit before.
Okay. And was was when you arrived, who, if you can recollect, were the candidates that were already there?
Already there?
Yeah.
That's a hard question for me because some of the candidates I have no interest in and don't know who they were. So, I mean, I knew they were candidates, but I couldn't tell you who was there.
That's what I said, if you know.
Yeah, I know.
Do you recall and do you know when Senator Perdue came in?
I saw him at some point, but I don't recall the time.
Well, you know, you were asked about the video, the court has seen the video, and we talked about the video, and I'm really not going to play it again, okay? You saw Senator Perdue arrive.
At some point, yes.
Yes. You saw him enter where the meeting lead was, correct?
I don't know. Are you talking about the video?
Yes.
Yeah, some of the video, yes.
And you saw that Ms. Tisdale was filming him, correct?
On the video, yes.
And you saw Mr. and Mrs. Burt in their greeting, now Senator Perdue, correct?
I saw them talking. I don't know who they were talking to.
You know, when you were performing your security duties, I guess at that particular point, where were you located?
I was all over the place. I mean, you have people coming in from the parking lot, so I spent time in the parking lot. Once different candidates started arriving, I followed behind, followed in. Then I would, you know, once they seemed like they were mingling or safe, I went back outside. So all over the place. I mean, I was in the barn in the area known as the Gore Shack in the parking lot. I was in several places.
But you weren't there when Senator Perdue came into the meet and greet.
I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, I could have been behind them. I could have been just on the other side of the frame of the cameras. I don't know.
How about Governor Deal? Were you there when Governor Deal came?
I don't recall where I was.
Well, did you see him arrive?
I don't remember when I saw him arrive. I know that Governor Deal at some point arrived, and though I was around Governor Deal at some point after he arrived, but I don't remember where I was when he arrived.
Okay, that's what I was asking.
Okay.
And you don't remember what time he arrived?
I don't.
How about Attorney General Owens?
I don't even know if I knew who Sam Owens was before that thing.
Did you see, well, obviously you didn't see him because you didn't know who he was.
Well, I could have saw him, I just don't know who he was.
Yeah, that's so right.
I could have talked to him, could have shook his hand, but I just don't know who he was.
Okay. Now, while you were walking around, you didn't encounter Ms. Tisdale, correct?
Not that I'm aware of, but I may have saw her, like I said. I mean, nothing that was stood out to make me be able to remember seeing her at another location, though.
Okay, sure. And if she arrived earlier and walked around and talked with folks, that's nothing that you would have any knowledge of, correct?
Could have seen her, could not have. Right.
You weren't present for any conversation that she may or may not have had with Mrs. Burt.
Not at all.
Okay. And as I understand it, prior to the time of this particular event, you had no contact with her, no knowledge of her, or any other encounter with her, correct?
Like I said, not that I know of. She didn't stand out. I don't remember seeing her anywhere else at the event, but at some point, I'm sure we walked by each other or somewhere in the vicinity because it's not like a huge area, so.
Well, did you see, the event started with Mr. Bearden introducing the speakers.
I believe so.
That?
I believe so.
Report?
So I do believe so. I was right there. I watched the video. It looks like that's a good situation, catches.
Right. And if you recall, Mr. Bearden didn't introduce himself.
No idea. Other than watching the video, I didn't see it in the video.
Okay. Didn't introduce himself and didn't introduce himself as anybody related to either Burt's farm, or anybody?
Not that I remember the video.
Okay. And in fact, I think he said, welcome to Burt's farm. We want to thank them for being the hosts, and we're going to get to the speakers, right?
I guess. I mean,
whatever
the video shows, is, okay. I guess the same thing. But I'm going to tell you, I wasn't standing at that right by them at that location. So I'm going based on the video that y'all have shown. That's the same thing I said.
So did that refresh your recollection as to what happened?
Refresh my recollection because I just said I wasn't there when Clint Beard. I was still different areas of the property. So I didn't recollect because I wasn't at that particular location at the time.
Okay. Now, Miss Tisdale was sitting in the front row, correct?
I think the front row, somewhere in that front area.
You did encounter her.
Did.
Are you saying you don't remember whether she was on the first row or the second row?
When I walk up to somebody, I don't count how many chairs are in front or behind.
So the answer is no, you don't recollect what row she was on.
I just said I think she was close to the front, if not in front row, the one at the front right there. That's what I said when I was asked by both of you.
The answer is no.
The answer is exactly what I said.
When you first saw her, she was filming, correct?
When I saw her, when I was walking towards her, she was filming, correct?
Did you see her before that?
I told you I don't know the answer to that question. We may have saw each other, we may not have, I don't know.
No, I'm talking about during the speeches. We're at the speeches. We're talking about Mr. Bearden has introduced the speaker. Ms. Tisdale is in the front. You have no idea. You don't remember whether she was on the front row, the second row, or the third row.
I didn't say that. Okay. I said she was either in the front or close to the front.
Right, that's what you said.
Yes, but I didn't say front, second, third.
Did you see her?
I did. At some point, I walked up to her. That's what I'm saying. I don't know what point you're asking me when I seen her. That's what I'm asking.
Did you see her before you walked up to her?
I don't know what point we saw each other when she walks in. I've answered that question. I don't know what you're asking.
After the speeches started.
After the speeches started. I would, at the point.
Can I finish my question?
Sure, I was trying to answer the question.
After Mr. Bearden, and while Mr. Bearden was introducing the speakers, did you see Ms. Tisdale recording?
Okay, let me answer this one more time, because I've answered this several times. At the point that Mr. Bearden was introducing those speakers, I don't know where I was. I could have been standing there close by, I could have been in the barn area. I can't answer that with a yes or no, because I don't know where I was. So, you said you swear to tell the truth, I'm telling the truth.
Did you see her recording the first speaker?
I did not, not to know of.
Did you see her recording the second speaker?
I don't know. I don't know. I was told, I became aware she was recording.
Your answer is, I don't know.
Okay, I don't know.
Did you see her start recording the third speaker?
I don't know what order the speakers were. So if I can elaborate, I'd be happy to answer the question. But I don't remember the order of the speakers. And to be honest with you, most of these events, I don't listen to the speakers.
Did you see anybody go talk to Ms. Tisdale prior to the time you talked?
Yes. Let's take it earlier. Can we answer it?
Now, who did you see first go speak with her?
I believe that would be the Max subject. The subject, his first name was Mac, I believe.
Okay. And if you saw him go speak to her, what was she doing while he talked to her?
What was she doing? She was recording.
Okay. And she was holding the camera, correct?
Sure.
The camera was pointed at the at the candidate.
Absolutely.
So you did see her and see where she was recording during the speeches.
I just said I don't know which speaker it was. I did see her during the speakers, but I don't know which one.
And Mr. Burgess, you believe, is the first person that went up to her, correct?
I believe.
And how long did he talk with her?
I don't know, because when I saw him, he was finished. You know, I don't know when he got there, so I can't give you the answer when he did. But
did you see him get out?
I saw him walk away from her.
Okay. And he walked away from her, and in which direction did he walk?
Towards me.
Did he come to you?
Did he come to me? No.
All right. Did he talk with you?
Yes.
How did he talk with you without coming to you?
He didn't come to me. We were passing each other. I stopped him.
Okay. All right. You stopped him?
Yeah. I'm trying to clarify. He didn't walk to go seek me. Okay. We were walking in the same general area when I stopped to talk to him.
Okay. And you talked with him?
I did.
All right. After you talked with him, where did you go?
Back to that same general area that was right there, next to the seating on the far side, I guess.
Okay. Had you seen or observed Ms. Tisdale making any loud noises at the time?
No, sir.
Saying anything?
Not that I know.
Asking any questions?
Not that I know.
Do you recall who was seated behind her or around her?
I know at some point that Clint Bearden was behind her when he was talking to her.
But you didn't observe whether anybody else was behind her taking pictures or audio recording?
I don't remember anybody else recording your photograph or anything else, no.
Do you remember where Governor Deal and his wife?
Somewhere in that close proximity, but I can't remember exactly where they were.
Governor Deal was on the right side and close to the speakers, correct?
As I just said, I don't recall exactly where they're sitting, so it's hard to say correct from that.
Well, one of your tasks, of course, is to watch the candidates.
Sure, right? But 2 years later, it's hard to remember where everybody was sitting.
Sure. Do you remember any other candidates that were near the speakers or around the pickup truck? That was the focal point of
at some point I saw David Perdue. I don't know if I saw David Perdue, but I saw Congressman Doug Collins at that area.
Okay. I mean, one of your functions, of course, is to provide security for the candidates, right?
Sure.
So one of the things you want to do is keep tabs on where the candidates are.
And I would have at the time, but I can't remember 2 years ago where the seating room chart was then.
Sure. Now, you had a brief encounter with Mr. Burgess. Who was the next person you saw talk with Ms. Tisdale?
Clint Bearden.
And where was Clint Bearden when Clint Bearden talked to Ms. Tisdale?
Sitting, I guess, kind of behind her.
And do you recall how long that encounter lasted?
It was short. I don't recall how long it was.
Okay. You couldn't hear any of that encounter?
Could not.
Of course. After that encounter, Clint Bearden came back, as far as I understand it, and did he talk with you?
No, that when I went over and started talking to Tisdale.
Okay. When Clint Bearden came back, Clint Bearden didn't talk with you?
I don't remember Clint Bearden came back, so I mentioned that. I don't remember.
And do you remember whether Clint Bearden went to Ms. Tisdale's location after that?
After he talked to her?
Yes.
No,
back with you?
No, I don't recall him going with me.
So as I understand it, you're the only person that went back?
I didn't say that. I said I don't recall him going with me.
Okay. Well, was there, do you recall anybody else going with you?
I know I walked up. I don't know if somebody walked up behind me. I wasn't, I don't have eyes in the back of my
head. Do you know whether Clint Bearden was behind Ms. Tisdale?
I just said I don't know.
And Ms. Tisdale, when you walked up to her, was still recording.
She was.
And that recorder has a microphone on it.
Does?
And you've heard and seen some of the recordings, correct?
You hear muffled sounds of people talking, but you can't hear what's been said.
There's a very short period of some muffled conversation on that recording, correct?
Yes.
But as you said, you couldn't tell what you said, or you couldn't tell anything that she said, correct?
On the recording?
Yeah, on the recording.
I can tell on the recording.
Okay. And maybe I'm mistaken, but I think that you said that the conversation was pretty short.
I said approximately 25 seconds, maybe 30.
And in those 30 seconds, we've got no sound, no recording, no conversation, correct?
Well, you're the muffled speaking. I'm assuming that's me and her just talking. I can't.
And I understand that you came up on the left-hand side of her.
I came up to her left, kind of the left front, as I explained, probably between 10 and 11 o'clock.
And how close were you to her?
Very.
And you were speaking to her?
Yes.
Now, she was still holding the recorder in her right hand.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Did you say, "Hi, I'm Clint Bearden with the Sheriff's Department"?
What is it, Clint Bearden? Because I'm not Clint Bearden.
I mean, I'm sorry. Tony Wooten or Captain Wooten?
I told you before I came up and I told her I was with the Sheriff's Office. I can't recall if I said Tony Wooten.
All right. And as I understand it, did she, when you say she refused, did she say the owner or Mrs. Burt gave me permission?
She said I have the owner's permission, and she told me no.
Okay. So when you said the owner, according to you, the owner said that she couldn't record, she responded by saying, I have the owner's permission.
And I responded by saying I just left the owner, and they told me to tell you that you need to either stop or leave.
Okay. And when you say she refused again, what did she respond?
No.
Nothing?
No. She said no.
No. Okay. And was that no really loud?
I'm not a judge of how many decibels people talk. I mean, I understood her saying no.
Well, we couldn't even hear it on the...
That's what I said. I don't know how loud it was. I know that she said no.
And you said, well, I'm going to take you out and you're going to go to jail.
I told her that she had three options. It was to stop recording and stay, or if she could leave, like they asked her to do, and if she didn't want to do either, then she was, you know, the other option, she could go to jail.
Okay. And at that point, did she respond?
She did not.
Okay. So you did what at that point?
Like I said before, I placed one hand in her hand, camera area, another on her arm, and the point she jumped out.
So your left hand went in front of the camera?
I'm assuming that's my hand. I know I went for that hand area there, so I must have, yeah.
Because we can see...
That's what I said. I assume that's my hand.
All right. And your right hand went to where?
Around your arm. On her arm.
It would be on her left arm.
Could have been.
Well, if you were on her left side.
Could have been. It could have been right. I could have reached across, but I think it was your left arm.
Well, if you had your left hand in front of the camera and you're on her left side, you're reaching to her left arm.
And that's what I said. I believe that's so. But it could have been the right arm where she had the camera. I can't remember the time.
And it was after you grabbed her left arm that she came out of her seat.
Yes, at that point she stood up.
Okay, so she stood up. She stood up voluntarily because you had her camera blocked. And
well,
you
I
had
didn't
her
say it was voluntarily. I said she stood up.
Okay, did you pull her up?
I was going to lift her up at the same time she stood up. So it would be both me pulling her up and her getting up.
And then you were escorting her out of the location. The barn where the...
Sure.
Okay. Now, it was you escorting her out, correct?
Sure.
She wasn't voluntarily going with you.
Absolutely not. She was fighting.
She was fighting because she's a tough lady.
There's a violating the law.
Objection, Judge. If she's a tough lady, that's coming to her.
You, you were, in fact, forcibly taking her out of that location.
Sure.
And you were forcibly taking her out of that location by attempting to, as best as you could, physically restrain her, correct?
Explain that for me, that way I can make sure I answered like you like.
Well, you had a hold of her arm.
Sure.
You were exercising the third option.
I was removing her, yes.
Okay. Well, you told us that there were three options. The last one was you going to jail.
Sure.
She had not responded to you. She responded twice saying she had permission.
She said no.
And then you were exercising the third option.
I've asked three times and she's refusing to do anything and tell me no.
She was clearly taken and escorted by you in your custody at that particular point, correct?
Escorted as she fought.
She was clearly in your custody at that particular point, correct?
I was trying to, yes.
Okay. And you physically had taken a hold of her and were physically escorting her to the... another location, correct?
I've answered that several times.
So the answer is yes?
Well, the answer is yes, and as she was fighting with me, wasn't that I've answered it several times. I don't know how to answer it for you.
Is that the way she was filming?
some point, because she's in the photo filming that way.
Well, do you recognize that as the candidate that was speaking when you engaged?
I think so, but like I said, I don't pay attention to all these candidates that we see once in our life.
Right, but is that the way she was holding her camera?
When I approached, she was holding her, yes.
I also want to hand you what's been marked as plaintiff 16, defendant 16, 17, and 18. If you look at those. Do those photographs accurately represent you with Ms. Tisdale taking her to the the counter?
Can you explain what accurately? Sure. Can we explain what accurately represents?
Yes. Are they photographs that show the activities of you taking this?
Shows the activities of me escorting her fighting both, yes.
Sure. I guess that you heard her continually say, please identify yourself.
I did.
Did you identify yourself?
Not at that point. I did after we got out of the barn, after she calmed down, after I had her trained.
Sure. So my question was, did you identify yourself at that time?
Which time are we talking about?
When she was saying, please identify yourself.
Not the time between the court and the barn.
Right. So she was continually saying, please identify yourself. Correct. At that point, she was also saying that she had talked to the owner. Correct.
Not at the time. I don't remember if during the time that she's being escorted out, if she said that. I don't remember that.
And when you got her to the counter, she was continuing to say, I talked to the owner, correct?
Yeah, she said she talked to Kathy Burt. Yes, then okay. Mr. Burt came in and said that she had not.
No. Did you listen to the video?
Several times.
Okay. He didn't say you had not. He said, I'm the owner.
Okay. Well,
and I say no.
I was busy restraining your client. I have no idea exactly what all I got to
say. But you can listen to a video.
Sure.
And you can accurately
repeat. If you play it, I'll be able to tell you accurately.
Instead of making up stuff.
I didn't make up stuff. I'm going by my best recollection.
Is that a question or a lecture?
Both.
Ask a question.
It wasn't a question.
Okay. You understood, you saw on the video that he said, I am the owner and I say no.
I guess. I don't remember exactly what all he said.
Well, it's important, isn't it? The words that are used.
That's
are
why
important.
I think you ask him. He told you what he said. It's on the video.
And you reviewed the video, correct?
I have. I've seen the video.
And it's important that words that you say in court are accurate, correct?
It is. That's why I'm trying to explain. I don't know exactly what got said. I didn't say it. He did.
When you got to the barn, or to the counter, to the checkout counter, as they call it, one of the things that you do, I guess, as a law enforcement officer, is to restrain as much as possible whatever subject you have. As much as possible, correct?
No, depends on the subject, how much that subject's resisting. You have some people that's under arrest that walk off, and you have very little physical control at all.
Okay, well, here's what you did with Miss Tisdale, as I recall. You had her arm, correct?
I did.
And you had
you had her, I guess, her right arm or her left arm?
Left arm at the time that we entered, so at some point I had both, but at one point it was left arm.
All right. Let me hand you what's been marked as defendant's exhibit 24. Let's see if you can identify that.
Okay.
Is that an accurate representation of you and Ms. Tisdale in the at the checkout counter?
Not sure, I guess at some point, yes.
Okay. She is face forward, correct?
She is.
She is bent over the checkout counter, correct?
Yes.
Right. And you have a hold of her right arm behind her back?
That point, yes.
I beg your pardon?
Yes, at that point, right arm.
Okay. And you are behind her.
No, actually to the side of her, as the picture clearly shows.
Picture clearly shows what it would show.
That's what it looks like to me. You're asking me what I thought it looked like, so answer your question.
All right, I move introduction of defendant's exhibit number 24.
Admitted.
No objection, sorry, Judge.
I think at one point, Ms. Tisdale says to you, I'm not going anywhere. You know, you don't have to put my arms behind my back. Do you remember her saying that?
Not that I recall, but I mean, we're continuously fighting, so regardless of what she said, her actions would have meant that I couldn't release her. I mean, you don't fight somebody, they continue to fight, and you release them while they're fighting. Oh yeah, she said, I'll leave. That's what she said. And then I said, sure. You know, we're past that. And you've already kicked me, elbowed me.
Was there anybody else there when that was said?
I don't know.
Was Mr. Burt there? Or was Mrs. Burt there?
I still don't know.
Did you hear anybody say, well, you know, we don't want to take her to jail?
I think at one point Mr. Burt come in and talked to me, and I said, you know, it's too late. She's already hit me, kicked me. I mean, at some point, you know, there's a line after you've used physical force to remove somebody and they've used physical force to resist, that the option of have a good day and hope you enjoy lunch is probably gone.
Okay. I know that you were abused during this exchange. Did you?
I didn't say abused. I said I was a kid.
So okay. Did you seek any medical attention?
Didn't.
Did you take any pictures?
Didn't have any visible injuries that required pictures.
Yes, and that's the same with the elbowing that you may have gotten.
I did get an elbow, not might have gotten, and I didn't have any visible injuries that required a photograph, as I said.
And I know that you have never encountered subjects that were alleging that they are being illegally arrested. You've never had that happen before, correct?
Well, there's always people that decide that they're going to fight and say that they don't want to go to jail.
Sure. And those people that were doing that, had you seen people committing a crime before?
Have I seen people committing a crime? Absolutely.
And you've arrested those people, correct?
Yes. Some have been released. I mean, I guess it depends on the crime of which instance we're talking about.
And I guess the crime that you saw Ms. Tisdale commit was filming quietly, the candidates, correct?
No, I'd be happy to explain. I saw her committing the crime of criminal trespass after being asked by three separate people to stop recording or leave after being identified as a sheriff's office employee, and I've asked her to leave three separate times. She committed the offense of criminal trespass, not quietly recording, and asked to leave.
I said, you don't know what Mr. Burgess said to her.
I said, I didn't.
You don't know what Mr. Beard said.
Other than what they testified to.
I also understand that at that particular point, at that point while Ms. Tisdale was still filming, that was the point where she asked you to identify yourself as well.
Which point was she still filming?
When you were picking her up and taking her and leaving her.
She didn't ask me to identify herself at that point that I recall. And I didn't pick her up, as I said. She stood up at the same time that I had hold of her arm.
You, what's been marked as just as defendants 25, 26, 27, 28.
And can I hand you those and see if you can identify those as
sure.
Stills from the video?
They do appear to be made from the video, yes.
I move to admit 25, 26, 27, and 28.
No objection.
Okay. I'm going to hand those up to you, please. Yeah, tell me, please, Mr. Wooten, first. We have been talking about, two particular physical events. One that you were kicked in the shin, correct?
Yes.
Where did that occur? When did that occur during this exchange?
Coming into the barn area from outside.
Coming into where the checkout counter is area?
Coming into it? Well, it was outside of that area, still outside the barn, I guess. Okay.
And tell us which leg you were kicked with.
Which leg I was kicked with? I don't know. I was kicked in both shins.
Okay, in both shins.
Yes.
All right. And when you were kicked in both shins, outside that area, was anybody else there?
I'm sure there was people walking, but I had my hands full trying to restrain your client.
Okay. And you were attempting to restrain her, correct?
Was.
All right, and I guess that she just hauled off and sort of kicked you.
Well, it's not real hard to kick somebody when you have their arms and their feet are free. So, yeah, she kicked me with her legs, with her feet.
The back of her foot or the front of her foot?
Sir, I didn't look down. I tried to continue to move her to the area of the barn.
And I'm assuming that there was a continuous physical contact with you in this Tisdale during this encounter, you're taking her to the checkout counter area.
You mean continuous as far as me still having her hand behind her back and escorting her to that area?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, still in contact.
And she was twisting around.
Yes.
Okay, is what you told me. And you were pushing her, correct?
I was trying to escort her. She was trying to get away, and I was trying to push her in that direction.
She had one arm on her. On her king of one, correct? Right?
Sure.
And you physically had her and were pushing her in a particular direction, correct?
Tempting to, yes. I was making my headway, but it was slowly.
And she was continuously during this particular period asking for you to identify yourself, correct?
She was, but I already said I identified myself before with physical conversation started, and I identified myself after she was restrained and stop lying.
So my question, the answer to my question is yes, during this period,
sure, she's still
she is continuing to request you to identify yourself.
Absolutely.
Right. And she was twisting around, right?
Yeah, she was twisting, trying to get away, making movements like she was trying to get away from me.
Okay. And you physically guided her into the checkout counter area, I guess the bar area, right?
Yes.
And you physically put her over the counter, correct? Now, where was the elbow?
Well, after we got in the barn area there, when we were still, wasn't like she went over the counter, nothing else happened. So there was still some physical altercation that took place there at that point.
Okay.
Sometime near the point, I don't know what point, how I can answer that.
Well,
after she was placed over the counter there, it wasn't that she stayed there. She came up, her body was flailing sideways, different directions. She was turned around at points, looking at me, points that she wasn't looking at me, so during that time.
Okay, well, we can see on the video that she was over the counter. She was yelling, essentially, that she had been given permission, that she had talked to Kathy Burt, correct?
Sure.
She was saying, at least at one point, you're hurting me, correct?
She was.
She yelled very loudly, at least, I know, six times, correct?
Sure.
All right. You didn't hear that on the video, correct?
Did I not hear it on the video?
Yeah.
I know that she yelled continuously. I know there's parts of the video where she didn't yell, and we talked calmly after the video stopped. I know there's a lot of things that happened in there. I know at points that she was yelling, there was no other force used that was used when she wasn't yelling, so I'm not sure why she'd be yelling.
What arm did she elbow you with?
I believe it was her right once we got inside the barn there, once we were trying to make an attempt to get her to the counter.
Right, sure. That's the one that on defendant's exhibit number 24, that's the one that you've got a hold of.
At that point, you showed me this here, I told you that I escorted her out, I believe, holding her left arm, so at some point, her left arm must have become free and struggled inside, and I've got a right arm at this point.
Okay. That's inside the checkout counter, right?
It's in the barn area.
She's bent over at that particular time, correct?
Of the picture you're talking
yes.
about? I can't really tell. I mean, she could be, I mean, I don't know how the barn, the thing is, I guess she's still laying on it.
And you have, at this particular point, her right arm in your grasp.
Sure.
Correct? Okay. But that's the arm that she elbowed you with.
I believe so when we come in. But I didn't have her right arm obviously behind her back when she elbowed me.
So I'm sorry.
Can I finish?
Yep.
Yeah. Because at one point, I obviously would have had her left hand. And you can see at this point, I don't have her left hand. So during her struggle, one hand came free and I got another hand.
No, it's not obvious which hand you had because you don't remember which hand.
I told you that I had her left hand outside and that right hand here. So it's pretty obvious we switched at some point.
Well, I didn't notice. When did you switch?
At some point during the struggle. Obviously, her left hand is not behind her back. Her right hand is.
So, as I understand it, then both the shin kicking and the elbowing occurred when you were coming in.
That's not what I said. I said the shin kicking happened outside the barn area.
Right. And the elbowing
inside the barn area after the continued struggle happened at the area of the cashier's checkout.
And when you were bringing her into the checkout area, that elbowing you believe to be the right arm.
Correct? Yes.
And we don't know what foot kicked you in either shin. Correct.
I promise you, I didn't look down to see which one it was.
Who else was there when you brought her in?
Like I said, sir, I have no idea. I didn't look around when you're in the middle of a confrontation with somebody struggling, elbowing you, kicking, you're not trying to see. Let me make sure I get all the list of people that are in here at the same time.
All right. And when you got in there, how long was it before Johnny Burt came in?
Not very long. I believe that his daughter was in there at some point. I know, I can't remember who was in there at different points. Obviously, you know, for those guys that were standing around, I was a little busy.
When you talked with Johnny Burt, did I understand you to say Johnny Burt said, what did he say?
Something to the effect, I don't know exactly, something to the effect of, can we let her go or something like that, I can't remember.
Okay. All right. That was
exactly that answer. Seriously,
Johnny Burt was your witness?
How does that make it hearsay? I'm sorry, Judge.
Mr. Burt, understand.
He's already testified, and you have the opportunity to ask him those questions.
Then he can recall him. It's still hearsay to come from Captain Wooten. He's offered for the truth of the matter asserted. It's still hearsay.
Okay, he's already testified.
And that makes it okay how?
Because you had the opportunity.
He was set. You can recall him if you want to.
But it's still hearsay.
Deny it. But I go over with the objection.
That was while you were in the checkout counter area, correct?
Sure, yes.
And that was also, was that before he said, I'm the owner, and I said no?
I can't recall.
Was it when Mr. Burt was close to where you were?
And he would have been in the barn area, so it's some, I don't know the distance, but he was in the barn area. So, okay. Yeah.
And if you were communicating with him, we could or should be able to hear that on the video, correct?
As I've said several times, that videotape is nowhere near as long as the actual conversation happened inside the barn area. There's a period where that videotape is obviously turned off, however it got turned off. And there's still a great period of time between that and then. I don't know what point that Mr. Burt said, so if it wasn't on the video, it must be probably after the video stopped.
Okay. And at that particular point, you responded that it's too late for
that. Did. I responded it's too late for that. She's kicked me, assaulted me. We've had to use force. She's resisted. Whole gamut of things was said, not just too late.
One moment, please. Understood that you stayed with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office until recently, correct?
Sure, about 6 weeks ago, yes.
You also were there, and you talked earlier about policy. Was there a policy change in the Dawson County Sheriff's Office about the attire that folks would wear at public events?
I can't recall.
You can't recall?
You ask, I answer, I can't recall.
No further questions today.
Mr. Finn.
Thank you.
I have no more rebuttal witnesses today. I don't have any more rebuttal witnesses for this motion.
Yeah. I don't have any more witnesses for this motion.
You have any witnesses on any of the other motions?
No. And let me make an announcement on the other motions. You know, one of the motions dealt with the videotape that we talked about. I'm gonna withdraw that motion. That's a subject for some debate, but I'm making the announcement. There is also a motion to disqualify the district attorney's office. I'm going to withdraw that motion too. So, are also grammatically speaking. So, there are no other motions then that are before the court. I think this is the motion that we will end with today.
things I thought about it. I had to deal with the judge told me to do, and I read the law and I thought about it.
Oh, I don't have to argue today, Judge. I can do it by brief. I can do it however you want me to do it.
I'd like some time to file a brief with you because I think this is a determinative issue. And I'd like a chance to get
all right.
This group argue.
How much time?
I don't know how soon.
I thought you were on trial, like, the team.
Next week. Right, so I'm going to need some time. I don't know how soon the court order will get well for this.
Well, we got 3 weeks of criminal trials in Dawson County in October. And I certainly was hoping that we might be able to resolve this case during that concerted effort to eliminate our criminal case backlog.
With all due respect to the court, and I really mean that, you know, everybody says that, but I do mean that. I don't think we're going to be able to brief these issues, get ready, and get any witnesses we need. Because if, and I say it, we try this case, it appears to me that there are going to be a number of witnesses who would be recipient witnesses and would have been testified about in this immunity hearing. That we need to accommodate with regard to their availability, including the governor of the state, the now, but soon to be former attorney general, et cetera. Now, a number of those people have been subpoenaed to this hearing, so I have contact with all those folks. But, for example, Purdue is in session. Congress, Governor Deal is out of the state, and I think their activities, actually they're excused from subpoenas during those activities. So I'm asking to adjourn from this final vote because I have a conflict, a two-week conflict that's going to be, I'm going to be in trial because I want to address these issues, and I think we're going to need and potentially special setting where we can arrange to get these folks here.
Mr. Greer.
Judge, may we approach?
Thank you. Yes, that's what you're saying. What y'all did?
What number did I call?
Thanks, Pat.
My name is Lacey.
Lacey.
Phone number, Mr. Lee Darrow, 770-531-6965.
We are strictly forbidden by ethical rules to discuss the case at all. But I, procedure and things, I'm always glad to answer those questions.
Thank you a lot.
Yes, sir.
Jim, this is my husband. And this is David Milam. I got my website from David. He had created a vow for silence. Before blogging was really even part of it, he was kind of in